Okay, hi everyone. Welcome to today's lesson. Okay, we want to discuss the holidays homework that I gave you. Now, this is on page 94. I give you three exercises, one on subtraction, one on multiplication, and one on division. Okay, let's look at subtraction first. Now, I'll only choose a few to discuss so the video doesn't get too long. Okay, let's look at 1E. So 547,000 minus 88,000 minus 398,000. So we minus one by one. So we minus 88,000 first. Now be careful of how you arrange. The cents and the cents must be in the same row. The ones, tens, hundreds, the thousands, the 10,000 in the same row. And this additional five here is for the hundred thousands. Okay, so you minus zero minus zero. Now this one you have to borrow. When you borrow, you plus 10 minus 1. So 13 minus 9 is 4. 2, you have to borrow again. Plus 10 becomes 12 minus 1. So this one is 7. Again, you have to borrow. Plus 10 minus 1. This is 8. Plus 10 minus 1. This is 9 plus 10 minus 1. This is 8 plus 10 minus 1. It's 5. This is 4. Then we minus the second number. Now remember to write your RM. Without RM, you're losing your mark. 398,473 ringgit and 45 cents. Okay, this one, not enough. You have to borrow plus 10 minus 1. So this one you minus. Borrow again because 3 cannot minus 4. Plus 10 minus 1. Decimal point you have to put. 6 minus 3 is 3. 8 minus 7. 9 minus 4. 8 minus 8. Plus 10 minus 1. 15 minus 9 is 6. Then your RM, remember. So you get your answer 60,513 ringgit and 95 cents. Look at question 2. Based on the information given, calculate the balance. Jari baki simpanan. Balance of savings. So you have savings of 250,000, 138 ringgit and 70 cents. So you spend money on business capital, nah, buat perniagaan, and then you buy furniture, beli perabot. So you have to minus these two expenses. Okay, tolak perbelanjaan. So 250,000 simpanan, tolak 85,000. So 85 right here, because this is 10,000, this is thousands. So 85,000 is here, 250 ringgit. Now there's no cents here. So I don't have to write the cents. Okay, this one you have 70 cent, 70 cent, ini tak ada cent, so di sini. Kalau awak nak tulis cent, dia pun point sifar sifar. So tolak. Okay, tolak. Pinjam, tambah 10, tolak 1. Tambah 10. Ini dapat 9, ini tolak 1. Tambah 10, tolak 1. Okay, so after you minus, you get this number. And then you have to minus the perabot. Tolak perabot, 16,000. 16 di sini. Sebab ini ribu, ini puluh ribu. So 16,000 di sini, 745 ringgit. Again, there's no cent. Tak ada cent di belakang. Kalau nak tulis pun, point sifar sifar. And then you tolak. Plus 10 minus 1. 1 minus nothing, 1. So you get 148,143 ringgit and 70 cents. Question 3. 410,000 minus unknown equals this. What is the unknown? So you take the bigger number, nombor yang besar, tolak nombor yang kecil. So 410,000 973 ringgit minus 286,342 ringgit. Now cara susunan sangat penting ya. Ini sa, puluh, ratus, ribu, puluh ribu, ratus ribu. Susun dengan betul. Kemudian baru tolak. This one plus 10 minus 1. Plus 10 minus 1. The final answer, 124,633 ringgit. Okay, this for subtraction, let's go to multiplication. Okay, for multiplication, this is on page 96. Okay, page 96. Okay, when you times 10, 100, 1000, very easy. You move the decimal to the right. Gerak titik ke kanan. So, darab 10, gerak sekali ke kanan. So, you get 475,508.5. So, ini tambah sifar di belakang, jadi 50 sen. Darab 100, gerak titik 2 kali ke belakang. So you get this answer, 246,032 ringgit. Darab 1000, gerak titik 3 kali ke belakang. 1, 2 and 3, tambah lagi satu sifar. So you get 799,680 ringgit. Okay, let's try 3C, the hard one. Choose the difficult one. 69 times 2,157 ringgit and 90 cents. Okay, there are two numbers here. Ada dua nombor. So the first number is I use 9 to times. So saya guna 9 untuk darab. Okay, I use 9 to times first. So 9 times 0, 9 times 9, 9, 7, 63, plus 8, 71, 9, 5, 45, plus 7, 52, 9, 1, 9, plus 5, 14, 9, 2, 18, plus 1, 19. Okay. Then second row, you start with a 0. Okay, baris kedua selalu mula dengan sifar. Tadi saya guna 9, sekarang saya guna 6. 6 times 0, 0. 6, 9, 54. 6, 7, 42, plus 5, 47. 6, 5, 30. Plus 4, 34. 6, 1, 6, plus 3, 9. 6, 2, 12. And then you plus, ini tambah ya. Okay, so is this the final answer? Not yet. Alright. You have a decimal point here. So ini two decimal places, dua tempat. So dua tempat sini. Dua tempat maksudnya ada dua nombor di belakang. And then your RM. Okay. Alright. Then we look at question 2. Now quantity here means bilangan. Bilangan. Ada 3, 56, 70. Ini ialah harga per unit. Price per unit. So to find the total price, you have to times. Okay, satu barang, ini rumah kan, terrace house. Satu rumah 286,000. So tiga rumah, tiga darab. And then you dapat jawapan. Satu air purifier, penapis udara, 1,700. 56 unit, darab 56. You dapat jawapan. Satu peti sejuk 3,400. 70 unit darab 70. You get your answer. Okay. Alright, now we move on to division. It's on page 98. Okay, page 98. So just now when you times, bila darab, kita gerak titik ke kanan. Sekarang bila bahagi, kita gerak titik ke kiri. So bahagi 100, gerak ke kiri dari luar. Dari luar sini, sekali, dua kali. Titik. So you get 3,428 ringgit and 70 cents. Soalan B, bagi 10, satu sifar gerak satu kali. Titik sini. So you get 76,510 ringgit and 90 cents. Bila bagi 1,000, tiga sifar gerak tiga kali ke kiri. 1, 2, 3. Titik. So you get 519 ringgit and 60 cents. Divide 1,000, move 3 times to the left. 1, 2 and 3, titik. So you get 842 ringgit and 30 cents. Okay? Okay, question 2, I just choose a difficult one. Okay, let's do D. ringgit and 80 cents divided by 24. Now we have never done CFIR 24, so we have to build our own CFIR 24. So on your left you write 2, on your right you write 4. So on your left I do CFIR 2, 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 3 to 6, 4 to 8, 5 to 10, 6 to 12, 7 to 14. On your right, we do CFIR 4, 1, 4, 4, 2, 4, 8, 3, 4, 12, 4, 4, 16, 5, 4, 20, 6, 4, 24, 7, 4, 28. And then you put them together, 24, 2 and 4, 24, 4 and 8, 48. 6 and 12, you take 6 plus 1 first, you get 7, and then 2, you copy. 8 plus 1, 9, copy 6. 10 plus 2, 12, copy 0, 12 plus 2, 14, copy 4. 14 plus 2, 16, copy 8. So this is your CFIR 24. Okay, so let's divide. Now, we cannot use 6 because it's smaller. We need bigger than 64. We need a bigger than 24 number, so we use 61. Okay, look at the number here. We have to choose the closest to 61, but smaller than 61. Okay, nombor mesti terdekat 61 dan kecil daripada 61. So that is the nearest is 48. 72 dah lebih. So we choose 48. This is the second number, right? The first, the second. So yang kedua, we tulis 2. 2 darab 24, 48. Okay, 48. And then you minus. Okay. Bring down 6, 136. Closest is 120. Because ini dah lebih. So this is the 3rd, 4th, 5th. This is the 5th one. Okay, yang kelima. So 5 times 24, 120. And then you minus. Bring down 5. Okay, 165, the closest is 144. Because 168 is bigger. So this is the 6th one. 6 times 24, 144. Minus is 21. Check, make sure it's smaller. Then we bring down 6. Okay, 216. That means we have to continue the CFIR 24. It just now we stop at 7, so this is 8. 8 times 2, 16. 8 times 4, 32. This one we get 192. We do another one, we go for 9. 9, 2, 18. 9, 4, 36. This one, 21, 6. Ah, there we have it. 2, 16 is the 9th one. So 9 times 24. Is 216, and then bring down 4. Now this one is obviously 0. When you see this number is smaller than 24, this number is smaller than the one divided, straight away write 0. then we have 4. Okay, then your decimal, don't forget, bring down 8. 48 is the second one. 2 times 24 is 48. Bring down 0. 0 times 24 is 0. So the answer is 25,690 ringgit and 20 cents. When I see you tomorrow for our class, we want to talk about mixed operation involving money. Okay, so remember the sequence when we do mixed operation. The priority, if we have brackets, okay, kalau ada kurungan, kita selesaikan yang dalam kurungan. Okay, the first one is always the one in the brackets. Then after that, we do the multiplication and the division. Then lastly, we only do the plus and the minus. Okay, look at this one example here. 6,800 plus 3 times 150. So here we don't have bracket, but we have plus and times. So we have to do the times first. Selesaikan yang darab. So you have to times this one first, 3 times 150. Can you see the one in red? 3 times 150, you get 450, 450 ringgit. Then only you plus 6,800, then you get your answer. Okay, darab dulu yang merah ini, baru tambah. So itu yang saya maksud dia, turutan dia. Darab dulu, baru tambah. Okay, so you can look through the examples here in your book. This is page 99. Okay, page 99, get yourself ready, and I'll see you in on the online class tomorrow. Okay, that's all for today. Please be punctual tomorrow. Bye bye.